Namaste, Bhagavan. We will read questions now. First, we will read in Russian, then in English. Okay? Dear Bhagavan, you are saying that the awakened one does nothing, but leaves nothing undone, for all things are happening all the time around and through the awakened one. So while being awakened, does one still have the desire to accomplish goals which are material in nature? For instance, to become rich, to open up and develop one's business, to participate in the competitive struggle, and so on. Could you please tell us about how will it look from viewpoint of a detached observer, and what it would feel like from the inside when one is awakened? What does it mean everything happens automatically? Does it mean that thinking happens and decisions are being made and the awakened one is just watching it as a movie? Is life still interesting to the awakened one if he does nothing? Thank you that you are with us.
Now, assume you are riding in a car on a highway and that you are moving very fast. And then suddenly you find a truck in front of you and you instantly apply the brakes. Who applied the brakes? You did not apply the brakes. It was your unconscious mind which applied the brakes. The unconscious mind is 2 million times more powerful than your conscious mind, and most of the time it is the unconscious which is working. But the conscious mind thinks it is doing things itself. The unawakened man takes credit for all that the unconscious mind does. The awakened person is fully aware that the unconscious is functioning most of the time. The awakened person is constantly witnessing the unconscious mind at work.
Yes.
Therefore, while all things are going on, he feels that he is doing nothing. You should therefore not imagine that the awakened man actually does nothing. The awakened man actually does a lot of things, but only thing is he feels that he is not doing anything. Just like when you applied the brakes to the car, you really know that you did not do it. The awakened person can do all that the unawakened does. He can make money, he can grow rich, he can have a family, he can have everything, but still he would only feel that he is witnessing things.
Dear Bhagavan, you are saying that for the awakened one, everything is perfect. That means he has no incentive to change anything around him. What about the technological progress during the golden age? How will it happen? And how the changes will occur in the lives of the people? Will everything stop with love?
The unconscious mind, which I spoke of earlier, would be engaged in thinking about change, scientific progress, technological progress. Everything would be as usual as before, but things would happen much, much faster. Only thing is, you'd be like a bystander, like a witness. Please translate.
Namaste, precious and beloved Bhagavan. Somewhere deep inside, I believe that I will have enlightenment someday, for instance, in a month, but not today. My mind always determines the time when this will happen, and there is no real faith in me that it can happen right now. Can this belief delay the moment of the enlightenment? Or is it not to be considered as an obstacle for the divine? I love you very much. Please, Bhagavan, bless us all for the enlightenment and God realization.
This lack of faith in people, this lack of is really a problem which we have got to overcome.
Dear Bhagavan, earlier I thought that I do easy and constantly communicate to you inwardly. But when I started to practice bhakti yoga at home, everything seemed artificial to me. When I do a ritual, my mind cannot get the sense out of doing offerings because the divine will not physically use that which I offer. When I do not see any sense in it, the resistance appears and I cannot feel anything. I just do it mechanically as if I'm doing an exercise which I just must do. The communication to the divine itself during bhakti yoga becomes awkward and unnatural to me. It doesn't come from my heart. It feels just unnatural. Bhagavan, what can I do here? How can I feel? What am I doing? Thank you, Bhagavan.
While doing the Bhakti Yoga, we are trying to connect to the collective conscious mind, which is beyond the unconscious, which we call God. We have to go through the unconscious mind before we could get in touch with the collective conscious mind, which we call God. The unconscious mind understands symbols and rituals. That is why we have symbols and rituals. If, however, you are uncomfortable with rituals, you could devise your own way of communicating to the unconscious.
Dear beloved Bhagavan, is it important while doing the rituals which are a part of Bhakti Yoga to follow the traditional way of doing it which we saw in India? Or the main thing here is our communication to the divine while doing it? If we do not do it 100% correctly, if we do not have all the necessary components for those rituals, how does this influence the power of a ritual? Thank you, Bhagavan.
It is not that you must be 100% accurate. What is important is the intent behind the ritual. Intent is 100% accuracy. Even if the ritual is not 100% accurate, you would still get the results.
Thank you, Bhagavan.
Yes.
We love you, Bhagavan.
So, love you all. Love you so much. So, we will now meditate for a few minutes. The whole purpose of this meditation is to take you through the unconscious and put you in touch with what we call the collective conscious mind or God. If we succeed in that, everything is over.
Откройте глаза и получите благословение Шри Бхагавана.